Hey everybody, I'm Crow. Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon. Not a whole lot happened this time, since we couldn't afford the armor upgrade, or weapon rather, because we need two more deeds. So I sent some people off to go and drop some stress, and trained a couple abilities. Nothing exciting. Plus 4% crit of torches. No, the torch isn't going to be that low. I'm not interested in that. Medium. Short. Short. Busts and a buckle. Three crests. I do have an Eldritch Slayer's ring. I also messed around with trinkets. I gave two things to Renald. That was basically all that happened. Crests. Ooh. Still, it's a medium. If we're going to do a medium, which we might be able to do now, I'm going to go into it with a fully, like, ideal party. So, short, short, and short. So between these, the Beast Slayer's ring, I think, is the most appealing. So him in the front, we're actually going to move him back. She's going to go there. He's going to go there. I think that's how I wanted to do it. And then have him in the back. Because he wants to be in the front too and doesn't really want to be in that position. He's still good from the second position. And she's the strongest in the front. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two. Full food. A key. And one of each of these, just in case. Ready to go! Took 2 minutes to get out this time. But more things happen. A lot more to consider with the party.
I knew all these paths once. Now they are as twisted as my own ambitions.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hey, it's only two. And the party formation was switched up. There's absolutely nothing he can do from the very front. He, however, can hound Harry from anywhere.
Precision and power.
Oh, they're not... they're in the front. You can't actually do anything about that. 5 stress. Wow, we got put into a pretty... like, I think that was the worst we could have been shuffled. I mean, I can break through from anywhere.
Give them no quarter.
Pretty much. Blackjack.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Actually, I think it was our formation that was broken there.
This expedition at least promises success.
I'm trying to move you. Thank you very mucho. Heirlooms! Those are okay. I mean, they're not deeds or paintings, but portraits, whatever they were called. No scouting.
Watch your step.
Oh good, he resisted. It was just stress. Food. Eat some food. You'll feel less stressed. That's how that works, right? Food makes everybody feel better. Except for when it poisons them. Resistances are intense. Hounds Harry!
A decisive bubbling.
Play grenades.
A singular strike.
Get smitten. Smited. Whatever it is. Look at him taking up two positions by himself. I'm glad he resisted that. Out of all the people you could have done that to, really? You're gonna be a jerk? Stun him! Resist.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Well, he'll die next turn, so we can just focus on the big guy then. Smite! And rush.
Your size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
You can heal yourself. And you kill.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Yay, stress relief. Killing people always makes them feel better.
Or is it merely a trick of the light?
I didn't even think about that. That wasn't their tent. It was the tent of one of their victims. Yeah, I guess that could be pretty stressful. I wish backtracking didn't mess with them so much. The Jester guy has a good quirk.
Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
Yeah, he has a good quirk for countering that, though. I don't know if it completely negates it. Scouting, yes! Okay, so nothing serious in the room, then. I was expecting it to be like, somebody's head was in there, everybody died from stress. It's so nice when things don't go terribly wrong. And we'll loop around and then go up. Dug in haste? Oh, it uses the item when it doesn't have an effect. I never noticed. Oh, grave dug in haste. Shovel.
A handsome reward for a task well performed.
Exactly the two deeds we need. I don't know why I didn't think about digging these up. I'm so dumb. Alright. Our positions weren't all messed up. 110%. 110%. That's only for the front two. Okay, I was like... Which one of these has a better chance of blighting him? With almost a 100% chance of doing it, I failed. And then everyone was stressed out. Breakthrough! Hit them all! I haven't had a good cleave comp in a long time. Only 5 damage. These guys... Ah, the protections. They take a third less damage. That's disappointing. He's not gonna be hitting them very hard, then. Hazard. Rush. That one. 1 HP and bleeding, so we can hit these guys.
The ground quakes.
Gone. Don't grow her. What's wrong with you people? 55% less damage, full damage. He doesn't
as
get a turn.
Falls, a faint hope blossoms.
And neither do you? Now he gets a turn. Or not, actually. I thought he still had a round to go. He resisted that. But we wickedly hacked him to bits.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Every time I start feeling good, this guy just puts me down. It's like, we're doing it, guys. This dungeon's nothing. And he's like, remember, we could kill you at any second. Okay, it's true, but still. Open it. Sack's empty. At least it wasn't full of explosives. Wow, there was no fights in here. Okay. I have a shovel. Looks like grave digging pays off. Two more deeds. Loads of money. Oh, should have used another torch. We're probably gonna fight. Nope. Continue adventuring then. As we move on to the last room. Something inside the trunk. It's just a tree. This is gonna hurt.
Nature herself, a victim to the spreading corruption. Malformed with misintent.
There's some light. Nothing to fight. So we just got a little bit of unnecessary stress there. But we know now.
Paths and roads bring soldiers and supplies. Let them arrive unharried.
Wow, there was a lot less, stuff there. Like, I'm pretty sure we started that dungeon this episode. It's only been 10 minutes. Or 11? Whatever. It was quick. And he really is, he's just one away. Oh, and then he was out of the party. Look, I don't care about your other quirks, but you're not stealing my stuff. You were one away from three. Why did you have to do this, Renald? Why?
The shadows hide the guilty and the guilt-ridden.
In the ensuing melee of the two men escape the scene are said to be at large. They are assuredly armed and dangerous and desperate. Idle highwaymen's gain one resolve level. Really? Did they both? Were they zeros before? What does it mean, one resolve level? Like, do they get the credit for having completed one more dungeon? Oh well, I'll fix all this stuff up and then before the next... Well, we'll start the next dungeon. Okay, so Renald has to get his kleptomania fixed. He got his, only can do one thing to remove stress thing cured because that caretaker guy was in it before. So now he's getting de-stressed. Pistris is getting de-stressed. Pont is getting de-stressed. And we're ready to head out again. Oh, and I spent the 8 or whatever crests on making this stuff cheaper. Because this is way, way, way too expensive. 25,000 and 15,000? Nah. And still, no Crusaders or Clerics. I've been checking every single time we come back, even if it hasn't been on camera. For these last few episodes, at least. Embark. She still needs to be in front, he needs to be in back. He's going to be ranked 2, which is going to be exciting. More weapon and armor upgrades. Or at least a weapon upgrade. Then we're going to do him in the back, and her from second to back. So that we have a pretty good party. And then we look around. This is long, medium, medium, medium. Okay, so I think it's like, if it has the 3 points, it's a medium mission. And if it has 5, it's a long mission. 9 deeds, wow. 2 campfires. That's really awesome, but there's no way we could do that. We would need... If I had these two and Renald and somebody else, I think I might be able to try it, but... Actually... I don't know. I mean, these guys are... Can we do a medium mission? How stressed are they? Not like at all. I'm worried. Let's try it. Kill one wizened hag. Snap bones. All we have to do is kill one lady. And this gives crests and a bunch of deeds. Veteran, no. It's level 1. If things start looking bad, we'll abandon it. I want to try it. Ah, this could be scary. We have firewood. Let's get tons of food. Alright, we are super prepared for this. We could not buy any more food. Let's get a bunch of shovels. We get a ton of gold for this. I might be breaking even, but I would rather break even and make it out with the heirlooms than not get through this at all. I mean, I think we're going to want at least one skeleton key. Let's grab two just in case. This could be used to maybe get us some more food or something. We already have an anti-venom, so might need another one. It's probably implying that there's a lot of blight here. Bleeding I don't care about because it's not as bad as blight. Yeah, let's grab a holy water just in case. I think that if we were going to do it, this might be okay.
I had collected many rare and elusive volumes on ancient herbal properties, and was set to enjoy several weeks immersed in comfortable study. My work was interrupted, however, by a singularly striking young woman who insisted on repeated calls to the house.
Ancestors' Memoirs, The Hag, 1 out of 3. I didn't realize how long that was going to take, my bad.
There is method in the wild corruption here. It bears a form both wretched and malevolent.
Wow, so this is just like a tuning fork. So there's going to be lots of backtracking here, regardless of which direction we go. Probably go down. But we're going to have to do that next time. I'm sorry for the really weird ending here. But thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you liked it. Later, everybody.